guys, it's Jane here from Cafe. Today I'm going to be interviewing a local Toronto artist. Her name is Faith Fetish. Absolutely incredible work. We're going to talk a little bit about cannabis and creativity. When did you first discover you had a passion for the arts?
A couple years ago, actually. I was really struggling with mental health, and I found art was like the only way that I could find to really be still. So it was almost like a form of meditation.
So you're self-taught?
Self-taught, yeah.
Does cannabis help you focus on your art?
Absolutely. Like, you know, like I'm the kind of person who has a lot of energy, and my creative brain is just all over the place all the time. So smoking weed is what allows me to get into that transcendent state where I can really go inwards into a piece and be still. And that's kind of where I find my focus.
What is your preferred method of consuming cannabis?
100% smoking a joint. I just love the act of smoking a joint. I get inspiration of watching the smoke swirl. It's just a whole process from rolling it to smoking it.
There's a ton of different strains in the cannabis world. Do you have a favorite, or do you use specific strains for specific results?
My favorite strain for creative purposes is definitely Tangerine Dream, or any like primarily sativa based strain, I would say.
So you're not an indica smoker?
I smoke everything.
It was a trick question.
For creative purposes, definitely sativas, but at the end of the night when I want to go to sleep, an indica's awesome.
How does cannabis influence your creativity?
The main thing for me and why I love cannabis and creativity and why they go hand in hand is because it introduces the concept of divergent thinking. So it's a different way of looking at the same thing. So every time I smoke, I go back, I look at the painting, and then I see different things that I wouldn't see when I'm focused in on an area for so long.
What is the hardest part in creating your artistic piece?
A lot of the times I have a very specific idea in my mind of what I want to create on canvas. And as my process continues to evolve, the end result also continues to evolve. And sometimes that can be challenging, especially with custom commissions where the client has something very specific in mind. And then my divergent brain is like, well, how about we make it even cooler and add all this stuff? And maybe that's not exactly what they wanted. So it's really important to know where to draw the line with how creative you can get when you're working with clients as opposed to working for yourself.
How long does it take you to finish a painting?
Oh God, it can take anywhere from like a day, which is like a full 14 hours of being focused, to a couple weeks or a couple months.
So do you have any role models or anyone that inspires you in the industry?
Absolutely. I mean, I follow a lot of artists on Instagram, but definitely my favorite one right now is Sage Barnes. And he's an artist that's always pushing the boundaries. He's always doing new things. And that's something that I aspire to do too, is just to always try new things and never be stuck to like one specific style or one specific niche.
How would you describe your paintings?
I want my artwork to be a reflection of my personality, which is vibrant, energetic, colorful, movement, life, energy, you know? And that's what I want people to have in their homes. It's like a little piece of life.